Hi and welcome, this is My Architecture. Today I'm joined by Farouk from Sony Music The Orchard. Hi Farouk.
Hi, thank you for having me today.
You're welcome. So tell us what The Orchard is doing.
The Orchard, we are a music company that we process and distribute music for labels to distribution platforms such as Apple Music, Spotify, and even physical locations. We also provide services so that they can collect their accounting, royalty collection, and other services such as publishing.
Okay, and please tell us of some of the challenges that you have to solve.
At The Orchard, we are huge proponents of teams having control of their own stacks. So our publishing team would have full control end-to-end from database all the way through the application on what stack they choose, as in the best tool for the job. That creates another problem because you want to provide a seamless user experience to our customers. Thus, you need data for interoperability between these systems. As you can imagine, it's hard to provide a good search system when you need data from two other different teams.
Gotcha. And I'm really curious, how did you solve all these challenges?
So the way that we solve this challenge is by identifying the need for a message bus. Think about it as a central queue where all your information is flowing through in real time.
Okay.
And consumers that want it can subscribe and pull from there.
And the message bus, I presume, is implemented using MSK, Managed Streaming for Kafka, is that right?
Yes, that is correct. So we have built a stack called Kafka Data Highway, and at its core, we have MSK as the central message bus.
Awesome. So why did you specifically choose that service?
I do have to say the stars came together. At the moment that we identified we needed a system like this was just about the time that Amazon was making in private beta managed streaming for Kafka. We're a huge AWS shop, so it just made sense for us to be able to use something in an ecosystem that we're used to, and there's guarantees of new features and services that come out will support this.
Okay, maybe we look at the use cases. So what are the core use cases that this enables?
So it enables us to do two main different patterns. One is real-time replication between data sources.
Okay.
And another one is event-driven architecture.
Okay, cool. Let's start with the data replication use case. So how are the bits and pieces connected to each other?
Okay, so I'll take an example of a use case for a real-time data application,
right,
which is essentially providing a good search experience to our end users.
Okay. So how do you do that?
So we long ago knew that Elasticsearch is really powerful and gives you a lot of tools for quick and powerful searching of any kind of data to users. We wanted to use that, but the way that our stack is set up, going back to initially best teams for the best job, our knowledge graph, our corpus of data is contained within Neo4j, which we have hosted on EC2 here.
Okay.
So we need a way to, in real time, get that all the way into OpenSearch.
Yeah.
So we're moving data from Neo4j into MSK using something called the Streams plugin, which gives you a direct connection from Neo4j to MSK.
Okay.
Now cool. Remember, Elasticsearch is powerful for other things such as ranking and boosting, so we can augment the search and give users better relevant results by incorporating analytical information into there. So we have whole bunch of data coming in from channels for your streaming numbers, for your social metrics that go into our data lake, and from there via an S3 Kafka connector we also push that to MSK.
Nice. So all the data is stored now in MSK, and what's the next step? Where do you do the join? How do you combine the data?
The next thing is we join the data on the fly through an Elasticsearch sync connector.
Okay.
So it's an open source off-the-shelf Kafka connector that you just plug in, you give it the destination of the Elasticsearch URL, and also the origin topics that you want it to consume from. And you join those two pieces of information to push directly into OpenSearch. That allows you to do powerful things such as, let's say there's 100 Beyoncés in the world. I go into the application, I search. I want my search results to be ranked according to relevance, right?
Yeah.
Which one has the most social metrics? Which one gets the most consumption?
Cool. And can you maybe talk us a bit about the impact of this type of architecture? So what did this really enable?
So this architecture enables our customers to have really topical information at the tip of their hands, right?
Right.
Something is created in the wild. A new artist comes into existence. New music, appears, right? you can instantaneously search and find relevant content that you care about.
Right.
You can do, you know, market intelligence really quickly and make marketing decisions or A&R decisions even based off of that.
Gotcha. So it really enables a faster business insight, and so you can make faster decisions and move forward, right?
Exactly.
Cool. And another use case that you're doing with the platform was also related around enabling new types of processes and integrating services in an innovative way. Can you maybe talk about that as well?
Exactly. Now that we have a message queue at the core of our system here, one thing that we can do is we can bring events that happen typically between systems and bring them closer to users. As an example, mm-hmm. you might have stakeholders that care about when the name of an album has changed or the release date has changed.
Right.
So at The Orchard, we have microservices to deal with certain entities such as that as an album, right? So we have a microservice that's hosted on Fargate that we can then decide, hey, anything that changes on an album, you change the name of it or the date that it releases, push that event, that business object, to Kafka.
Okay. So the microservice running on Fargate, a business event happens, and instantly you distribute the information to Kafka.
Exactly.
Okay, cool. And then how does it go on?
So then you can really leverage, as in if there are stakeholders, humans that care about anything that has changed, you can have a Lambda that's reading from that particular topic to send an email to them to notify them something has changed. Or you're using an external service, let's say a marketing CRM, to create a landing page.
Right.
You have this amazing landing page saying my release is coming out in 10 days. That has now changed.
Mm-hmm.
You can use HTTP sync connector, that's also open source, to tell the CRM, hey, the release date has actually changed, therefore update your systems and update your website.
Okay, cool. Yeah, thanks for giving us this overview and sharing this architecture with us.
Thank you very much.
And thanks for watching This Is My Architecture.